another at Hustedde Gymnasium in Dennis Strader Court for this JV match between the Wildcats from Lovejoy High School and your Gibault Hawks. We're about a minute into the JV game. Lovejoy has a 2-0 lead on two free throws. Gibault with the ball. Nice basket inside there by Gavin Kessler. That's a three-pointer for Lovejoy. Number four. The basket up and inside. That one goes to Andy Altus. Steal there by Gibault. They get it up ahead to Hudson Blank, who lays it in. Hudson Blank with the layup after the steal by Gibault. Gibault goes up top to Owen Meckler. Then to Cannon Augustine. Now Gavin Kessler. Hudson Blank top of the key. Meckler near side. Three-pointer by Meckler. Way too strong. Rebound goes to Lovejoy. Number 12 quickly down the court. Pulls up, goes to 35. Back outside to number 4. Pulls up his dribble. Now number 12 in the corner. They try to go inside to Hudson Blank. Hudson Blank tried to grab that pass, went off his hands out of bounds. The ball will remain with Lovejoy. Lovejoy with the ball, tried to drive baseline, cut off. Ball stolen by Hudson Blank. Quickly down court. Coast to coast, Hudson Blank with the basket for Gibault. Number 21 drives, ran into his own man there. Shot went off the front of the rim, rebound to Cannon Augustine for Gibault. Gives it to Hudson Blank, he drives, close in the lane, and it goes in. Two more points for Hudson Blank. 10-5 lead for the Hawks. First quarter. Foul on the drive on Andy Altus. His first. Team second. Gavin Kessler also with one foul so far for Gibault. Apologies, I do not have a roster for the JV team. Travel called there on 21 for Lovejoy. I'll see if I can get one at halftime so we get their players' names as well. Meckler brings the ball down court for Gibault. Now to Augustine, drives lane. Foul called on the drive, I believe, on number 12. Indeed, second team foul on Lovejoy. Attempted inbounds to Augustine, stolen by number 12. He's driving down the court. Dishes to 44, layup no good. Rebound to Peyton Schaefer. Cannon Augustine now brings the ball down for Gibault. Drives lane. Traveled on the drive. Turnover to Lovejoy. Thank you. past the 44, top of the key. They dish it around. Far side, three-point attempt, no good. Rebound to Cannon Augustine. Quickly down court. Pulls it up. Lost his dribble. Turnover. Ball goes back to Lovejoy. Timeout on the floor. 10-5 lead for the Hawks. 3:30 left to go in the first quarter. Pardon me while I do a little audio check here. Check, check. Check on the audio. There we go. We're back underway here. Ball stolen there by Hudson Blank again. Lays it up and in. 8 points now for Hudson Blank. And it's a 12-5 lead for the Hawks. Number 21 drives baseline. Spin move. Goes up and under. Off the glass and in. Nice move there by number 21. For Lovejoy on that basket. Peyton Schaefer gives it to Meckler. Now back up top to Hudson Blank. Gives it to Cannon Augustine. Dribbles top of the key. Takes the three-pointer. That one's short. Hudson Blank able to get that one before it goes out of bounds. Now back to Cannon. Hudson Blank drives. Scoop shot up and in. And a foul. 10 points already in the first quarter alone for Hudson Blank, and he's going to go to the line. Foul on number 35 for the Wildcats, his first, team's third. Free throw for Blank is good. For Lovejoy, brings the ball up court, drives down the lane, looking for a place to go, up and decides to go low with the ball, goes under, little scoop shot up and in, right back, guess who, Hudson Blank with another layup, 13 points now for Hudson Blank, that's a 17-9 lead for the Hawks. Go inside to 35. Back up top to number 4. Guarded by Augustine. And Gibault knocks the ball away, and it's picked up by Ryan Biffer. Now hands off to Blank. They go to Meckler in the corner. Thinks about the three. No good. And Ryan Biffer's going to be called for over the back on that rebound. That'll be his first foul. Lovejoy able to inbound. We got 1:39 to go here, first quarter. Andy Altus with the pressure. Drives down the lane, up and off the glass. Basket good for number 21. That's 6 points for him on the night. High scoring first quarter so far, 17-11 in favor of the Hawks. All up, they go out to Meckler, thought about three, doesn't take it, drives lane, little floater, too strong, won't go, rebound. By Peyton Schaefer, put back up, he was fouled. And he'll go to the line shooting two. First free throw from Schaefer. No good. Second one coming for Schaefer. That one much better. One out of two from the line for Schaefer. It's a 7-point lead for the Hawks. Just under 1 minute to go in the first quarter. Soft pressure from the Hawks. Kenan Augustine on number 15, able to get the steal. Comes away with it, gives it to Meckler. Had Kessler driving down court. Didn't see him. Kessler now backs his way in. Goes outside, three-point attempt. Spins out, no good. Rebound to number 35 for the Wildcats. 30 seconds to go. See if they hold for one shot or not. Got in the far corner now. Good defense by Ryan Biffer. Comes away with the steal. Gibault with 15 seconds to go. Meckler brings the ball down court. Under 10 to go. They give it to Augustine. 6 to go. Augustine fouled by number 15 with 4.2 on the clock. The fifth team foul. Kessler drives to the basket, puts it up and off the glass with 1 second to go. And that is the first quarter with Gibault leading 20-11. Leading the way was Hudson Blank with 13 points for Gibault. It will be Lovejoy Ball to begin the second quarter. Number 12 guarded by Blank. This is the 23 in the corner. Three-pointer, no good. Kessler went up for the rebound. Ball was knocked out of his hands and out of bounds by Lovejoy. So the ball goes back to Gibault. Kessler thought about three, gives it to Biffer. Biffer now to Schaefer, back to Biffer, Kessler in the corner. Switches to Biffer in the corner, they go inside to Schaefer, back out to Hudson Blank, drives lane, pulls it back out, they reset the offense. Augustine with the ball, look for Kessler driving baseline, nothing doing, they went back outside to Blank. And now they're playing the ball around the perimeter again. Augustine drives, gets it to Blank, puts up a three-pointer. Won't go. Battle for the rebound. goes out of bounds, and it will be Lovejoy ball. Almost stolen on that pass by Kessler. Instead, 21 drives to the lane, but he's called for a travel. Turnover, ball goes to Gibault. Hudson Blank with the ball for Gibault. Hudson Blank from the corner. Three-pointer is good for Hudson Blank. 16 points now for Hudson. 23-11 lead for the Hawks. Tight defense there by Cannon Augustine, but he'll be called for a foul. And my apologies, I've been calling this as if this was a game against Lovejoy, which the varsity game is, I believe, against Lovejoy, but this is Waterloo's JV team out there on the court. My apologies. Drive by Blank, he was fouled. Ball would not fall. Blank at the line shooting two. First one no good. Second one also no good. Find 23 for three, too strong. Rebound to Peyton Schaefer. Hudson Blank now with the ball for Gibault. Gives it to Cannon Augustine. Back up top to Hudson Blank, now to Gavin Kessler. Kessler pulls it back. Cannon Augustine now with the ball top of the key. Goes to Schaefer. Far side, back up top to Kessler. Back to Schaefer. Now to Augustine, he decides to put up a three. Well, no good, rebound to Waterloo. Number 15 with the ball, picks up his dribble. Drive down the lane by number 44. Wouldn't go down, rebound to Augustine for Gibault. Tries to drive all the way down, little scoop shot goes up and in for Cannon Augustine. And it's a 25-11 lead for the Hawks. Shot attempt on the inside by number 35, wouldn't go. Ball goes off Gibault and out of bounds. It'll remain Waterloo ball. And again, my apologies for those of you tuned in. Heard me saying Lovejoy. The varsity team is playing Lovejoy tonight. Was not aware that the JV game was against Waterloo and not Lovejoy. Three-pointer in the far corner, number 21. That's 9 points for him. And the lead is cut to 11. Andy Altus gives the ball up to Owen Meckler. Meckler drives down the lane. Right hand, won't go, rebound. That was Peyton Schaefer with the putback for Gibault. Waterloo with the ball in the lane, up top, number 12. Pulls up, gives it back out. Number 4 now, far corner, drive down the baseline. Up and under, won't go. 44 crashes the boards, puts it back up and in. Aggressive offensive rebound there for number 44. And it pays off with the basket. Augustine tries to drive lane, he's fouled. And that'll be 1-1 now for Gibault, seventh team foul. That foul was on number 23 for Waterloo, his first. Team 7. And we're back playing here. Turnover by Gibault. Waterloo now has the ball. Number 21, top of the key. Three-pointer. Too strong. Meckler went for the rebound, knocked out of his hands by number 21. It'll remain Gibault. It'll go to Gibault ball. .244 to go in the second quarter of this JV game. 27-16 lead for the Hawks. Meckler with the ball now for Gibault. Gives it to Hudson Blank. Hudson's had the hot hand tonight. He's got 16 points in just the first two quarters. Now Ryan Biffer with the ball. Back up top to Meckler. They go in the corner to Cannon Augustine. Tries to drive baseline. He's fouled by number 12, his second, and he'll go to the line shooting 1-1. Free throw from Cannon. First one, no good. Waterloo comes away with the rebound. Kick ball. We'll remain with Waterloo. Number 44 to inbound. trying to go inside to number 21. Gibault successfully knocks it off the Waterloo player, and it'll be a turnover that'll go to Gibault. Gavin Kessler to inbound. He goes into Hudson Blank. He'll bring the ball down court. Under 2 minutes to play, first half. Hudson Blank now near side to Ryan Biffer, brings it back up to the top of the key. Hands it to Andy Altus, now to Meckler. Meckler to Biffer. Gavin Kessler in the corner. Gives it to Biffer in the corner. They try to go inside. Tried to go inside to Altus. Ball was tapped out of bounds by Waterloo. It'll remain Gibault ball. 1:24 to go. They bring it in. Kessler now. Three-pointer, one rims out, rebound to Waterloo. Ryan Biffer with the defensive pressure. Found number 23, hands it off to 21. Backs his way in, gives it up to 44, and they reset the offense. They swing the ball all the way around. They thought about a three-pointer, but Gibault's defense got there quickly. Under a minute to play. First half. They're looking to go inside. They finally do get it to 21, but he leaves that layup short. Tie up on the rebound. Possession arrow goes to Gibault. 40.7 to go. Gavin Kessler with the ball, guarded by number 21. He's fouled. Second foul on 21. Gavin will go to the line, shooting 1-1. Ninth team foul on Waterloo. No good. Waterloo comes away with the rebound. They go quickly down court. They found 23 alone under the net. Fouled by Gibault, so basket was no good, but he'll go to the line shooting two. 16.4 to go. A chance to cut it to a single-digit lead. First one is good. Peyton Schaefer into the game for Ryan Biffer for Gibault. 2nd free throw, no good. Rebound, battle for it. Kessler comes away with it. Still a 10-point lead for the Hawks and 10 seconds to go in the first half. Cannon Augustine drives down, puts it up off the glass, doesn't go, but he's fouled with 4.5 to go. He'll shoot two. That foul is on number 23, his 2nd. There was a violation, I believe, on that first free throw. Gibault steals the inbound pass. After he made the free throw. Kessler for three. No good. Wasn't sure what happened on that first free throw, but there was no shot attempt. But whatever it was either a violation on someone. So that one got wiped off the books. Second free throw, however, was good. And at the end of the first half, Gibault leads 28-17, led by Hudson Blank, 16 points. We're going to let you listen to the Gibault Pep Band now, complete with alumni, and as it is alumni night here at Father Ed Hustedde Gymnasium. And we are back to the action here. Waterloo now going right to left. Gibault going left to right on your screen. Three-point attempt by Fink, no good. Rebound Waterloo, put back by Davis. Got some names at halftime, so. And Waterloo cuts it to a 9-point lead with that basket. Ball stolen by Schwer. Calls up, waits for his teammates, and Waterloo sets up the offense. Number 21 goes up off the glass. That was Fink. Ball was rebounded by Lopez, and he was fouled. They'll go to the line shooting two. First one, off the back iron, and goes through the net. Second free throw coming up. No good, rebound to Kessler. Meckler brings the ball up court for Gibault. Now to Hudson Blank, now to Cannon Augustine. Augustine up top to Meckler. Now to Altus, drives into the lane, dishes it back out to Augustine. Now to Blank, cuts through the lane, pulls up, gives it back out to Altus. Now to Kessler, now to Meckler. Meckler drives lane, goes back outside, just inside the three-point line. Shot no good, was rebounded there by Fink for Waterloo. Nice pass there. And easy layup for Schwer. And Waterloo's cut it to a 6-point game. Timeout on the floor. Timeout called by Gibault. It'll be Waterloo ball, trailing by six. Sorry, Gibault ball, up by six. Meckler with the ball. Gives it to Blank. Blank goes to Augustine. Now up top to Meckler. Back to Augustine. Back up top to Meckler. Hudson Blank now with the ball. Dribbles. Looking to drive. Instead gives it to Augustine. Top of the key. Andy Altus drove. Gave it to Blank. He drove. Gave it back out to Augustine. Now Blank in the corner. They go inside. Back outside to Hudson Blank. Kessler drives baseline, tries to go right hand. He's blocked by Lopez. That was, I think, got that block on that layup attempt by Kessler. Fink with the ball. Dishes to Lopez. Up off the glass, and he's fouled. Free throw by Lopez is good. Waterloo's cut this to a 3-point game. Gibault had a double-digit lead in that second quarter. It's now down to three. Augustine pulls up. Nothing but net. Cannon Augustine gets Gibault on the board in the second half. It's now 30-25. 5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Smith from the corner, no good. Battle for the rebound. Schwer comes away with it, but stolen by Gibault. Block there on Mekla by Fink. Gibault steals it right back. Blocked by Fink on Meckler. Augustine for three is good! Three-pointer for Cannon Augustine. Gibault back out to an eight-point lead, 33-25. Waterloo thought they had the momentum with that block, but Gibault with a steal. And then the three-pointer, shot no good by Fink. Rebound 44. Too strong. That was Davis on that rebound. Gibault came away with it. Augustine brings it down court, drives, up off the glass, count it, and a foul. Cannon Augustine with his 10th point. That foul on Schwer for Waterloo, his third, first team foul. Timeout on the floor. And it will be Cannon Augustine at the line, trying to complete the three-point play. Waterloo had cut the lead to three, but now seven straight points from Gibault, and they're back out to a 10-point lead. Free throw from Augustine. Spins out. That is the one thing that has not gone Gibault's way so far in this match. They are not shot well from the free throw line. Fink throws it across court to Smith. Smith now picks up his dribble top of the key. They go inside to Lopez. Dishes it back out to Schwer. Drives lane. Puts it up. Spins out. Rebound goes back to Lopez. Up and in. Seven points for Lopez on the night. Hudson Blank drives down the lane, right-handed layup. 18 points now for Hudson. Schwer with the ball. They try to go inside to Lopez. Knocked away, but picked up by Smith. Finds Schwer cutting. Pulls up in the lane. Gets it to fall. Hudson Blank with the ball for Gibault, gives it to Augustine. Now to Biffer. Back up top to Blank. Oh. Trying to go to Altus. Altus is starting to cut towards the net. Ball goes out of bounds. Turnover to Waterloo. Lohman brings the ball down court for Waterloo. Gives it to Stork. Now to Davis. Back to Lohman. They go all the way across the court to Fink. Puts up the three-pointer. Too strong. Rebound, Hudson Blank. Blank brings it down court. Gives it to Biffer near corner. Now to Hudson. Now Meckler. Andy Altus drives. Gives it back up top to Hudson Blank. Goes around the screen. And Gibault resets the offense. Meckler with the ball. Guarded by Lohman. Lohman with the steal. Good for charging. Lohman lays it up and in. Under 2 minutes to go. Third quarter. 37-31 lead for the Hawks. Hudson Blank right down the lane. Won't go. Gets his own rebound. Pushes it back out to the perimeter. And Gibault resets the offense. Altus with the ball. Drives. Gives it up to Meckler. Now to Blank. Back to Meckler, far corner. Another steal there by Lohman. He stepped out of bounds after getting that steal. And the ball will go back to Gibault. Biffer with the ball, called for a travel. It'll be Waterloo ball. Stafford inbounds, gives it to Lohman. Pushes it up court, guarded by Augustine. Well, behind the back dribble, goes down the lane, finds Stafford, he drives lane, loses his dribble, goes back outside to Fink. Fink drives lane, runs into Augustine, players go down, no foul called. Fink takes it to the basket, 11 points for him. 4-point lead now for the Hawks. Augustine puts it up, battle for the rebound, goes Waterloo's way. Blocking foul called on Meckler. Waterloo will go to the line, 38.7 to go. Chance to cut it to a 2-point game. Be Stork at the line for Waterloo. Looked like Meckler just leaned a little bit into that one and was called for the block. First free throw for Stork is good. Second free throw for Stork. That one goes in. 2-point game. Gibault is led by double digits multiple times during this game. Waterloo keeps clawing their way back. And there's a steal. Fink with the ball. Lays it up and in. We're all tied up. Blank with the ball, 16 seconds to go, all tied up to 37. 8 seconds. Gibault sets up the offense, Augustine drives. Little floater, won't go. Rebound, that shot won't count. And after three, we are all tied up at 37. It'll be Gibault ball to start the fourth quarter. Peyton Schaefer inbound for Gibault. Gets it into Augustine. Goes inside to Kessler. Kessler backs his way in, back up top to Blank for three. It's good! 21 points now for Hudson Blank. And Gibault needed that after Waterloo had come all the way back to tie the game. Now a turnover. Augustine comes away with the ball. Pulls up, goes inside to Kessler, up off the glass, and good! Biffer went for the steal, called for the foul. That'll be his second, fourth team foul on Gibault in the second half. Sorry, that is third foul on Biffer. Fink brings the ball up court for Waterloo. They go to Schwer. Back to Fink. Tries to find Schwer cutting, almost missed him. Had to grab that pass behind him. Good job keeping that ball in bounds. Fink with the drive, goes up and under Altus, no good. Hudson Blank comes away with the rebound for Gibault. Pushes it quickly down court. Gives it up to Augustine for three, no good. Rebound Gavin Kessler. Goes back up off the glass, it's good and caught it. He was fouled on that one and will have a chance for the three-point play. That foul called on Stafford, his third for Waterloo, their team second. Free throw for Kessler. It's good. Gibault with an 8-0 run to begin the fourth quarter, and they're back up by eight. All in only a minute and 20 seconds. Drive down the lane by Schwer, lost his dribble. Fortunately for Waterloo, went to Fink, throws it all the way back across the court to Schwer. They go inside to Lopez, up and in. Lopez has definitely got height on the Gibault defense. Waterloo consistently trying to go inside to him. Hudson Blank now with the ball, gives it to Augustine. Drives lane, gives it back out to Schaefer. Now Blank, guarded by Schwer. Now to Augustine, top of the key. Back to Blank. Oh! That's a pass to Augustine. Augustine went for a cut towards the net. No one was there. Out of bounds. Turnover to Waterloo. Schwer brings the ball down the court for Waterloo. Guarded by Augustine. They go inside to Lopez. Backs his way in. Up and in. Little spin move as he backed his way in and then uncontested to the net. Back to a four-point lead now. Soft pass, Andy Altus from inside the lane. Little seven-footer won't go. Rebound stolen by Blank. Well, tapped out of bounds. Ball goes back to Waterloo. Davis gives the ball in for Schwer. He's guarded by Andy Altus. 10 seconds to drive down the lane. Finds Davis in the corner. Guarded by Blank. Drives baseline. Goes up. And in. Davis with 7 points for Waterloo. We're back to a two-point game. Back and forth. Augustine drives, blocked by Fink. but rebounded by Gibault. Three-pointer, no good. Rebound to Waterloo. All the way down court to Lopez. Up and in, we're all tied up again. Timeout on the floor. Back and forth we go in this one. 4:20 to go. It's all tied up at 45. And it'll be Gibault ball. Cannon Augustine brings it down court for Gibault. Gives it to Kessler in the corner. He walks it back up to the top of the key. Picks up his dribble, looking for some help. Now gets it to Altus. Now to Meckler. Meckler goes to Kessler. Now to Augustine. Augustine drives, gives it back out to Meckler. Hudson Blank with the ball, picks up his dribble, gives it to Augustine. Attempted steal. Kessler drives. Found Altus going down the lane, won't go. Kessler up over Lopez is good. Gavin Kessler with 11 points. Quickly down court, the dish it underneath to Lopez, up and in, off the glass, back to a tie game. Augustine with the ball, drives to the lane, scoops it up and in. Cannon Augustine with 12 points. Roll with the ball. Gave it to Davis, to Lopez, now to Fink. Fink puts up a three-pointer, no good. Rebound, Hudson Blank. Gibault with a two-point lead, 2:30 to go in the game. Meckler with the ball, drives lane, leaves it short. Kessler comes away with the rebound, but he was fouled by Fink. That'll be three on Fink. Only the third team foul for Waterloo, so if Gibault is able to keep this lead, Waterloo's got a whole bunch of fouls that they have to give before they can send Gibault to the free throw line. Timeout on the floor, 2:22 to play. Team's coming back from the timeout. It'll be Gibault ball after that foul. Altus inbounding for Gibault. Tried to go to Meckler, went right through his legs. And right into the hands of Crawford for Waterloo. Sorry, for Smith for Waterloo. Three-pointer. Off the glass by Lopez. Has given Waterloo a one-point lead with 2 minutes to go. Their first lead since way back in the first quarter. Kessler with the ball, tied up. Timeout called by Gibault. Gibault led 25-11 at one point. It's now 50-49 Waterloo. Gibault has been unable to stop Lopez in the second half. He's got 19 points. He's definitely got a height advantage over the paint over Gibault. And they've taken advantage of that in this second half. Gibault inbound. Quick one, won't go for Kessler. Spun out of the rim. Waterloo comes away with the rebound. They go all the way down. Went to Davis. Looked like the ball was going to get tied up, but they gave Waterloo the timeout. 1:33 to go. Those of you tuning in for the varsity match against Lovejoy, that'll be on a separate stream that you can find on the Gibault YouTube channel. We'll switch over to that one right away after the conclusion of this match, as we've got alumni here. We've got a stage full of band members, both current and alumni. And so we'll get the stream on as soon as possible so you can enjoy the music from the Gibault Pep Band. It'll be Waterloo basketball when we come back from this timeout. Be Davis inbounding for Waterloo. They're looking to go to Lopez. They loft it way up high over the top. Now they go inside to Lopez, guarded by Kessler. Back out to Smith. Back to Lopez, guarded by Kessler. Looking to go to Davis underneath, can't find him. Now they go back up top to Fink, guarded by Blank. Fink with the ball. Looks like Waterloo's content running some clock here. Augustine with the steal. Quickly down court. Finds Kessler. Sorry, it was Andy Altus that went up on that one. He was fouled. He'll go to the line shooting two. Triple teamed, but Waterloo unable to get the block. That foul on number 12, Schwer. His fourth. Team's fourth. First free throw for Andy Altus. No good. Gibault not having a good night from the free throw line. Second free throw by Altus. That one rolls in. All tied up at 50. 1 minute to go. This. Steal by Kessler, but Waterloo gets it back. They picked up their dribble right before they crossed half court, tried to go to Lopez, and Kessler came in with the way with the steal. Now Fink with the ball in the corner, guarded by Blank. Drives baseline, tries to scoop it up. He was fouled. He'll go to the line shooting two. That foul will probably be on Kessler. Indeed it is. Second team foul on Gavin Kessler. 37.4 to go. We're all tied at 50. Fink with a chance to give Waterloo the lead from the free throw line. First one is good. 1 point lead for Waterloo. Biffer checks out. Meckler checks back in for Gibault. Second free throw for Fink. Is also good. Now it's a 2 point lead. Timeout on the floor. 37.4 to go. It'll be Hudson Blank inbounding for Gibault. Waterloo just plays a half-court defense. Augustine with the ball. We'll see whether Gibault plays for the tie or the win. Hudson Blank now with the ball. They go inside to Kessler. Backs his way in. Little hook shot is good! Andy Kessler, Gavin Kessler ties it up. 15 seconds to go. Timeout Waterloo with 10.2 left. Gavin Kessler with the little hook shot. Tied it up for Gibault. And Waterloo will most likely go for a last second shot here. And we will either go to overtime or we'll see. Both teams have two timeouts remaining. Neither team in the bonus. And it will be Waterloo basketball. Along this near sideline. Davis will inbound. He'll be guarded by Andy Altus on the inbounds pass. goes all the way across to Schwer. 7 seconds to go. Fink with the ball. And they give the foul. That foul on Cannon Augustine is first. Team sixth. So they had one foul to give. And they just gave it. Gibault chooses not to guard the inbound passer. Ball goes to Fink. Guarded by Blank. Drives, spins, puts it up with the buzzer. No good. And we're going to overtime. Fink throw from the top of the key. Was double teamed, tried a spin move. Couldn't really get a good shot off. And the buzzer sounded, and we've got 4 minutes of overtime now to decide this JV match. Jump ball here between, looks like Kessler and Fink. Gibault will be going left to right. Waterloo going right to left. Waterloo gets the tip. They try to go inside to Lopez. Knocked away by Augustine. And Gibault comes away with the ball. Augustine dribbles against Davis. Gives it to Meckler. Now to Kessler. Guarded by Fink. Kessler gives it back to Meckler. Now to Altus. Now to Augustine. Guarded by Davis. Pulls up for three. Goal! Aaron Augustine for three! Fink with the ball for Waterloo. Now gives it to Smith. Double team, stolen by Kessler. All the way to the basket, lays it up and in. Gavin Kessler with 15 points for Gibault. Davis gives it back to Schwer. Little hook pass over to Smith. Picks up his dribble. They try to go inside to Fink. Ball goes out of bounds. Turnover to Gibault. 2:43 to go in overtime. Augustine with the ball. Brings it across half court. Kessler pulls up. Too strong. Ball tapped out. That'll be out of bounds to go over to Waterloo. Kessler was feeling the hot hand. Took a step inside the three-point line. Took a quick shot. No good. And now Schwer brings it up for Waterloo. Guarded by Augustine. Augustine almost gets the steal on him. Now they get it over to Davis. Davis drives on Altus. Up and in, count it. Foul on Andy Altus, his second. Sorry, first foul on Andy Altus. And the free throw by Davis is good. 2-point game. Halfway through overtime. Oh, they find Hudson Blank driving down the baseline, but he can't finish. Augustine with a nice pass found Hudson Blank cutting, but he could not finish that basket. Waterloo comes away with it. Smith in the corner, picks up his dribble. Now they give it to Davis. Back up top to Fink. Trying to go inside to Lopez, stolen by Blank. And he was fouled. Yep, actually. Timeout. Called by Gibault, I believe. 1:29 to go. And we've got the Gibault Pep Band. Always fun having the alumni here. Ball swatted out. I believe that was Fink. Gibault resets the offense. Augustine pulls up, gives it to Meckler. Hudson Blank drives down the lane. He runs into Lopez, tries to scoop it in, wouldn't go. Davis quickly down court for Waterloo. Resets the offense, 1 minute to go. They go to Schwer in the corner, try to find Lopez in the middle. Refs say that ball goes off of Kessler. It'll remain Waterloo ball. They go to Lopez, guarded by Kessler. Looking for someone to pass to. Finally gets it to Schwer. Schwer gives it to Davis. Looking, trying to find Fink on the inside. And 3 seconds called on Fink. Turnover to Gibault. Thought that may have been a reach. Foul on Gibault, but Fink was called for 3 seconds. We got 33 seconds left on the clock. Gibault's up by two. Full court pressure now by Waterloo. And foul on Augustine by Davis. That's only the fifth team foul on Waterloo. They've still got to give one more before they can put Gibault in the bonus. 26.8 to go. They get it to Augustine. He's quickly fouled. That's the sixth team foul on Waterloo. Next one will put Gibault at the line. Where Gibault has not done very well tonight. They get it into Meckler. And he's fouled. 20.5 on the clock. Meckler will go to the line shooting 1-1. Needs to hit them both to keep this a two-possession game. First free throw from Meckler coming up. No good. Rebound to Davis. Waterloo with 15 seconds to go. Down by two. Timeout called by Waterloo. Thank you. Waterloo looks to inbounds. They get it in. 10 seconds to go. Drive by Schwer. Guarded by Blank. Three-pointer. Won't go. Gibault comes away with the rebound. And that's the winner. Hard-fought game in overtime. Gibault comes away with the victory. 57-55. This is Todd Bisk, your voice of Gibault Hawks Volleyball and Basketball Online. Thank you for tuning in to Gibault Hawks Basketball. We'll be switching over to the Varsity stream now for the game against Lovejoy. Thank you for tuning in.